Good morning, students. Transport in India, part 2. Modern means of transportation. In the last video, we have discussed about the land transport, that is roadways and railways. Now, in this video, we will discuss about the water and air, that is waterways and airways. Waterways. Importance of waterway. Waterway are the cheapest mode of transport in India, and it is the oldest method of transport also. Along the coastline of India, which is 6,000 kilometers, and inland navigable means the rivers which are useful for navigation. Its length is almost 14,500 kilometers, which is covering the rivers, canals, lakes and backwater. Second, it is a fuel efficient and environment friendly, means it is eco-friendly method of transportation as compared to other mode of transport. They are suitable for carrying heavy and bulky goods. So those materials, heavy or bulky materials which are not been able to carry by the roadways or railways can be carried easily by waterways. Despite all the favorable condition, waterways in India currently provides only 1% of the total means of transport in the country. Means still the people are not relying now on the waterways, but earlier the people rely on the waterways and they use this for moving from one place to another. Water transport. Now it have two categories. One is called the inland water transport and other is coastal shipping or coastal waterways. So inland waterways, it includes natural modes such as navigable rivers and artificial modes. Navigable rivers means the rivers which are perennial in nature and which have water throughout the year. Artificial modes means construction of canals which are very deep and wide, which can be used for navigation. So in India, the total length of inland navigation is 14,500 kilometers, and it is developed in the second 5-year plan. That is about 34 lakh of money has been invested in this. Inland waterways. In India, we have main inland waterways which has been used throughout the India, and this was set up by the Central Water Transport Corporation in 1967, and its headquarter is in Kolkata, and it's mainly engaged in the transportation of goods in inland waterways in Ganga, Brahmaputra and Hooghly, that is the region of Sundarban. You can see the dark color lines, that is the area of Ganga River, Brahmaputra and Hooghly River. Then the second one was started by the Inland Waterways Authority of India, that is called the IWAI, which came into existence in 1986 for the development and regulation of inland waterways for shipping and navigation, and its head office is in Noida. Noida is in Delhi, and from Delhi its work has been looked after. We have a national waterways. The first national waterway is the Ganga and Brahmaputra, and the tributaries still carry the largest part of river traffic. River traffic means boats and streamers that can be used in these rivers. Then the Ganga is navigable up to the length of 800 kilometers from its mouth up to Patna. Mouth means from the near the origin till the Patna in Bihar. Brahmaputra is navigable throughout the year because it have a good amount of water and carries about 50% of transport between the Assam and Kolkata. So the national waterways in India are, first the national waterway, that is Ganga, which is starting from Allahabad to Haldia in West Bengal, and is completing the covering the area of or the distance of 1,620 kilometer, and it is the longest national water highway. Second national water highway, that is national highway water number 2, is Brahmaputra River from Sialda to Dhuri in Assam. Third is national water number 3, which is in the Keral in the Kolan to Kottapuram and cover about 2005 kilometer long in the canal area. So not only in the northern India but in the southern India also we have number of waterways which is useful according to the season. Now those in southern India it is not useful more because most of the rivers are flowing in the peninsula region which is uneven area and the rivers here are seasonal in nature. So we have very less waterways in the southern, that is the National Waterway 4 is found in the Pondicherry, that is through the canals, tanks and rivers of Godavari. So it is known as NW4 and its length is about 1095 km. In the same way we have Odisha and West Bengal which is National Waterway 5 which is 623 km long and which is used for carrying the cargo such as coal and fertilizer from one place to another. Now next one is shipping. It is divided into two parts, that is called the coastal shipping and overseas shipping. Coastal shipping, India has the longest coastline from east to west, that is 7517 km, and it have a number of ports, 12 major ports and 200 non-major ports. 12 major ports are like Kandla, Mumbai, New Mumbai, Mamagua, Kochi, Mangalore, Pondicherry, Tuticorin, Madurai, Chennai. All these are the major ports. Along with that we have the smaller ports also. And these ports are important because these are cheapest also. And from this area it is easy to do the import and export of goods from one place to another. So you can see here in the map the number of important ports from where the export of the goods has been done to different countries. Now advantage of shipping, that is the coastal shipping, first it is eco-friendly. Eco-friendly means as compared to other modes of transport, it is eco-friendly. Second, saves fuel as compared to railway and airways, because railway and airways runs on the fuel, railways runs on the diesel as well as on electricity. Airways runs on the diesel, so consumption of the fossil fuel is more, but in coastal shipping it is very less. It reduces the burden of rail and road. Means the bulky goods which is carried through the rail or road has been reduced because of the waterways. It provides employment to thousands of people. Means if there is a coastal shipping, number of people get employment near the coast. Like loading and unloading of goods in the ships or in the big boats. Then it promotes tourism. People can come here to see the different water areas. The capital investment is less. Why it is less? Because the maintenance of ways is not to be done. Because it's a waterway, so there is no construction of any ways has been done. So because of that it is cheapest as compared to other means of transport. Like for the road and rails we have to lay down the lines. But in this we don't have to do anything. Disadvantages of waterways. First, slow speed. It is slowest means of transport as compared to other means. Second, failure of monsoon. Means failure of monsoon means the water level will decrease in the rivers and will make the navigation difficult, especially in the southern areas or in the southern India. Third, more risky. In southern India, it is more risky as it flows through the uneven area, so there are chances of accidents or it can be strike with any of the rock. So it is very difficult in southern region. And other reason is that if the water is less, so it is very difficult for the navigation. Then diversion of river. Diversion of river means we have the rivers which have plenty of water or sufficient water, but from these rivers canals has been taken out. So the water has diverted in canal for the irrigation purpose. So because of that, water or the volume of water decreases in rivers. So it makes the navigation difficult. Then deforestation. Deforestation in the hilly areas lead to the erosion of soil, because there is no roots to control the soil. So because of that, there is erosion, and this led to silting up of the bed, and the volume of water decreases in the river, means the depth of the river decreases. But these waterways are very important in the area of northeast India, especially during the monsoon season, because during the monsoon season they cut off by the roads and the railways, and they have only waterways to connect themselves with the other part or the isolated part of the country. Now, airways. Air transport is the modern and the quickest means of transport. They are managed by the AAI, that is called the Airport Authority of India Limited, and it put a lot of efforts in the latest technology to ensure the passengers' safety and quick handling of passengers and traffic. Means they are looking after the security of the passenger, as well as making the goods easily reach to or deliver to the different parts of the country or outside the country. In India, government first started air routes in 1920 between Mumbai to Kolkata, and second Kolkata to Rangoon. Rangoon at present is in Myanmar. Subsequently, during the 10th 5-year plan, expenditure of ₹12,928 crore was provided to the Ministry of Civil Aviation to spend for the development of air transport. Further, in 11th plan, this amount has increased and result into about 43,560 rupees, that is a crore rupees, for the expenditure or the expanding the air routes in India, that is the domestic as well as for the international airways. Here in the map you can see that India have the domestic flight, that is the ways you can see, the arrows has been shown, and even it is connected with the other countries while airways. Problems of air transport. First, competition. The airlines are facing a stiff competition from foreign airlines, which provides efficient and better services as compared to domestic flights. Second, lack of funds. The old aircrafts, which are very old, like 20 years or more than that, their machines are obsolete machines, their maintenance is poor, and government says that they don't have a lot of fund to make a changes in this. So because of that, we suffered. Third, poor quality of services means, like Indian Airlines and Air India, we have these. So they don't have the proper staff to fulfill the or to look after the passengers. So even they are not giving the that much of flight outside the India or inside the India also. Advantages of airways: fastest means of transport, so we can reach to any part of the world in hours. Second, free from geographical condition, means it can reach to any part of the world without any physical barrier, whether it's a mountain, a desert, ocean, snow covered peaks, it can cross anything with the help of different airways. It is important in the north and northeast India. What is important in north and northeast India? Because north and northeast India is a mountainous region, and reaching to this area is little difficult. So with the help of airways, it is easy to reach in this region. Helpful in emergency. How it is helpful? Because during the earthquake or fire in any area, it is able to airlift people and save their life. Next is helpful for defense of the country. defense of the country means it provides equipments, food, and whatever the requirement is there for the defense personnel, it can be provided with the help of airways. Disadvantages of airways: first, high cost of aviation turbine fuel, means diesel which has been used, is cost is more. Then high service taxes and other charges, along with the ticket fare, they also charges other things. Shortage of maintenance facilities, they are not taking care of everything in the flight, and even they are not maintaining the means of airways in a proper condition. High foreign exchange rate, competition from the foreign airlines, means the domestic flight and other countries' flight, they have a competition with the their fares and their with their services. Congestion at airport, airports are not big for the landing or takeoff of number of flights. Lack of qualified pilots and efficient technical manpower, they don't have the pilots which are very efficient and technical power to look after the damage of the aircrafts or any type of machinery. Air transport is adversely affected at the occurrence of fog, mist and stormy weather. Means because of the weather condition also, sometime taking off or landing is not possible. So it is very difficult and there are chances of accident. I think now the methods of transportation, its characteristics, advantages and disadvantages is clear to you all. If you have any question, you are free to ask. Thank you.